Lambert.
Where did you come up with the idea to write the film Fortress?
Fortress was inspired by living in Cranston, Rhode Island, and driving by the gothic-looking ACI. And always there was that mystery, you know, because it was this dramatic-looking facility. And I said, I wonder what it's like to be in there. And then I thought, man, I'd like to maybe do a prison film. And having never been in a prison, thankfully, at the time, I thought, well, there's prison films like Escape from Alcatraz and some other films. And I thought, what if instead of bars there were laser beams? And what if instead of guards there were robo-guards? And what if instead of you couldn't even dream of escaping? What if the warden, you know, could stop even that? And that's when Fortress came up, and I wrote an outline at 3 o'clock in the morning. I listened to the music of Sting, Fortress Around Your Heart, and that's how the title came up. And after spending some time, we ended up selling it. I brought my writing partner at the time to help me flesh some stuff out, and we sold it to 20th Century Fox.
How long did it take you to write the film?
Your first draft probably took about a month and a half. It's usually the outlining and looking at, you know, you're doing an escape film, so you start looking at, escapes and like films like everything from the Poseidon Adventure on. You know, you looked at different, films like that. And so it took about a month and a half. And it's one thing to write the script. That takes you almost to the 50-yard line. But then there's a whole another 50 yards you have to go to sell the project. And so we kind of created our own buzz around town by calling up different producers and saying, have you read this script, Fortress? Have you read the script, Fortress? We hear it's really hot. We created a buzz so that everybody in town was calling about our script.
Now, what was it like to walk on set and see your vision come to life?
It was incredible. First of all, you know, to work with an artist, and we had worked with this artist named Simon Merton, and his father was a designer for a lot of the old James Bond films. That was pretty cool to get those drawings. But then to walk onto the set, and my film happened to occur in Australia, and there's like 300 people were employed. They're building the things. You're walking on the set, and to know that you came up with this at 3 o'clock in the morning, and now you have 300 people working, and you're on this set, which is multi-tiered, was amazing. And, you know, the film itself is probably maybe 60% of what I wanted. I want to remake it.
Yep.
You know, it was still a phenomenal experience, and it was that sense of not everybody gets an opportunity to have their idea made into a, and at that point it was like an $11.3 million budget. It was awesome.
Now, do you have any tips for an aspiring screenwriter?
Absolutely. I think you need to write every day, or as much as you can every day. You need to read other books, read other scripts. You need to do lots and lots of rewriting, because the more you understand story, the more you break down stories. I mean, and there's a science to breaking down stories, and now there are more books available than ever before. I really recommend this book, How to Get Your Script Through the Hollywood Maze, by I think it's Linda. There's a Linda Seeger and a Linda Silbert, I think. How to make Sid Field's books. All these books, very, very helpful. And as one producer, Brian Grazer, said to me, it's one thing to know what the formula is, and you need to know what the formula is. Then you can break it. But you need to know the fundamentals. And you know, just try, strive to do the best you can, make the best characters you can, have the best story, try to make it unpredictable, and find your voice.
All right, and with that, I want to thank you.
My pleasure, man.